Video game genres are fucking weird and dumb, and they make pretty much no sense at all, and they don't give you any description of what the game is really. Which is bad because that's the only thing that they're supposed to do is describe the game. Now, the reason that I'm going into this is because my friend Kate, who I'm outing you right now, Kate, asked me a stupid question. She asked me a stupid fucking question. She asked me the stupid question, which was, is Breath of the Wild an RPG? Which, first of all, who fucking cares? What does it matter if Breath of the Wild is an RPG, first of all? Secondly, I don't know. I mean, I guess yes, but also no. I mean, what is an RPG at all, right? Then you have to define what an RPG is. I mean, it surely has RPG mechanics, but fucking everything has RPG mechanics. Fucking Assassin's Creed is an RPG now, I guess, right? And this isn't limited to RPGs. This is kind of just all genres in general of video games, is that they just don't properly do the thing that they're supposed to do. Genres do one thing. They help you categorize things. And video game genres don't do that. So let's talk about movies for a second, okay? If I were to tell you that I like seeing action movies, you have a pretty good idea of what that means, right? And if I am talking about action movies, I have a pretty good idea of what type of a movie an action movie is. So if someone tells me about a movie, right? If someone tells me about Fast and the Furious, and let's say that I'm some kind of idiot that lives under a rock and I've never heard of Fast and the Furious, right? Let's just say that that's who I am, okay? Let's say I'm some fucking idiot, okay? And I don't know what Fast and the Furious is, okay? And someone says, "Oh, you should watch Fast and the Furious." And I'm like, "I don't know. What is that?" And they're like, "Oh, it's an action movie." Well, I like action movies, right? We've established this prior. So I'll probably give it a shot, right? I'll ask you to tell me more about it. And then you're like, "Oh, you know, it's cars and explosions and driving around." And I'm like, "Yeah, that sounds like an action movie. Yeah, I'm in. Okay, sure." Right? Really super quick, and it's just a one-word description and you get it. Same with any kind of movie genre, right? Like dramas, romances, comedies, like any of those things, you get a pretty good idea of what the movie is from the genre. You get a good idea of what that experience is going to be like. Now think about video games for a second, okay? Let's say that you like RPGs, okay? Let's say you like RPGs. And then let's also say that you haven't heard of a game like Dragon Age, right? Let's say you haven't heard of Dragon Age. And I was going to recommend a game to you, and I think, "Oh, I know that you like RPGs. I'll recommend him Dragon Age," okay? So I say, "Hey, you should play Dragon Age." And then, of course, you ask me, "Well, what's Dragon Age?" And I would reply with, "Oh, it's an RPG." You would have a lot of follow-up questions, right? Like, you wouldn't just say, "Oh, okay, sure, I'm in." "Well, is it an action RPG? Is it a JRPG, Western RPG? You know, is it like anime and shit? Because a lot of RPGs are like anime and shit. Well, is it turn-based? Like, what type of a game are we talking here? What is the actual gameplay? What's the theme of the game? Like, what kind of emotion should I expect? Is it narrative heavy? Is it mechanics driven? Like, what? You don't know anything about the game from me telling you that it's an RPG. I mean, you can assume that it probably has a leveling system and some kind of character growth and character progression, but that's not really true all of the time because I've seen people refer to Ocarina of Time as an RPG, which, well, I can't really tell them they're wrong because the hill that I'm dying on here is that genres are stupid and that they don't make any sense, so I don't care what you call anything. But also, it doesn't have anything that you would traditionally see in an RPG. So if someone were to tell you you should play Ocarina of Time because it's an RPG, and my idea of an RPG is something like Final Fantasy, I would probably be pretty disappointed with that because it's just not what I'm expecting. Right? And we can do this with any genre. I'm doing it with RPG because it's just very simple and easy. But genuinely, you can do this with any genre. That's why when games are announced, you'll often see that they use like seven different genres. I mean, I was just watching the Game Awards and they announced this game that's like a first-person action adventure game with RPG and looting mechanics. And like, they just listed off like seven fucking different things. And that's why genres are just kind of like a fucking joke. Like, the biggest joke that people make is, "Oh, you know, it's the Dark Souls of X," or "It's the Dark Souls of this," which people meme on and think, "Oh, that's funny, you know, it's overused comparing everything to Dark Souls." But that's actually a lot more descriptive than actual genres. Those comparisons to other games actually tell you a lot about the game. Because if you like Dark Souls, right, if you've only played Dark Souls, and let's say you haven't played any other Souls-like game, right, then I can recommend other games to you using Dark Souls as a reference, right? I can say that it's a Souls-like, and you'll be like, "Oh, fuck yeah, I'm in, sure," right? let's say you also like, you know, like platforming games sometimes. So I could say, oh, you know, you like platforming, you know, Hollow Knight's kind of like the Dark Souls of like platformers and exploration games. It's just like a 2D version of Dark Souls, really. And then you think, oh, you know what? Sure, that's cool, right? Like, that's a really, really quick description. And then you get descriptions like roguelike, which is super common and overused. But then you also get things like Metroidvania. And these are just descriptions of other games. Like Rogue, for anyone that's just like a fucking zoomer and hasn't heard of it. Rogue is a game, right? Roguelike as a genre isn't referring to like rogues as in like assassins or D&D thieves or whatever. Like Rogue is a game. It's a game. So a roguelike is a game that's like Rogue. Like it's rogue-like. Does that make sense? I mean, it fucking should. It's just in the name. And then Metroidvania is Metroid and Castlevania, but it doesn't really take anything from Castlevania. It's just Metroid-like kind of sounds dumb, but Metroidvania sounds like super fucking dope. So I guess we just call it that. I don't know. Then we get Souls-likes. Here's the thing I fucking hate, okay? I'm just gonna call out Riot Games right now. Riot Games, you fucking suck. Because we used to have this with MOBAs, okay? MOBA, fucking terrible genre, okay? It makes no sense. What is a MOBA? It's a multiplayer online battle arena. First of all, fuck you, what does that even mean? Okay, does that, I mean, fighting games are technically MOBAs then, right? I mean, they're multiplayer online battle. There's an arena, I guess. Like, a lot of things are. And then you start to think, well, isn't that Call of Duty? Because it's multiplayer, it's online, it's battling. You're in an arena of sorts, right? Like it tells you so much little information. The reason Riot did this is because they copied a game called Dota. And I want to be clear here. I'm not saying that Riot shouldn't have copied Dota. Obviously they should have. Who fucking cares, right? Copy whatever you want. If you do it better, you did it better. All right, congratulations. But they were self-conscious about the fact that they had copied another game and they wanted to hide it. So what they did is they pushed this new title. So instead of calling it a Dota clone, which is what MOBAs used to be called, or a Dota-like, Dota clone, those kind of things were really common back in the day. Now they're called MOBAs because Riot pushed for them to be called MOBAs instead, because it's just, you know, it's less demeaning of a name, I guess, but it's so much less descriptive. Because if you're around video games, you know what Dota is probably, right? So saying that a game is like, oh, it's a Dota-like, then you're like, oh, okay, cool. So there's like the three lanes and the minions and then the towers, and then you're trying to kill the nexuses, and there's the champions and you control one of them. And then you say, yeah, it's a fucking Dota-like. Did I fucking stutter? I think that there's this trend in video games that's kind of like that Riot Games situation where a lot of people seem to think that comparing one game to another is a bad thing, or that saying that a game copied another or is like another game or is a clone or whatever, they think that those are demeaning terms or that they're bad terms or it's not very nice to those games. People don't really like the overuse of calling something a Souls-like or the Dark Souls of this. People generally kind of hate that, but it's how we should be communicating, because these genres are terrible. Right? Like, there's no way for us to have a good conversation about games and what types of games are through the use of these genres that are, you know, oh, it's a shooter game. It's a first-person shooter. It's a third-person shooter. What does that mean? Because, I mean, Mass Effect is a third-person shooter, but Mass Effect also is pretty much just an RPG, right? But then we get back into what is an RPG. It's just dumb, right? It's just, it doesn't make any sense, okay? Mass Effect should just be its own genre. It's just this cool thing, and you're like, oh yeah, you know, it's like Mass Effect. Or CRPG. CRPG is a stupid fucking term, you know, computer RPG. It really just means that it's Baldur's Gate. That's all that it means. When someone says CRPG, they just mean that it's Baldur's Gate. It's just a new version of Baldur's Gate. Divinity 2, Baldur's Gate is just Baldur's Gate. Baldur's Gate 3, that's just Baldur's Gate. It's all just Baldur's Gate. Fucking, I mean, Disco Elysium, honestly, is kind of like just a narrative version of Baldur's Gate without combat, right? Have I said Baldur's Gate enough? Baldur's Gate. So I'm kind of going off on quite a bit of a tangent and quite a bit of a rant here. So I'm not going to apologize for that, because that's pretty much just all that I do. I think that this is an important topic, though. Like, I think this is something that people should be thinking about, because I think we really should be changing the way that we talk about games. Because these comparisons to one game to another, it's not demeaning. It's not saying that there's something wrong with copying another game. All games copy each other, okay? Everything is derivative of something else. There's nothing wrong with that. As long as you're not blatantly outright stealing something, right? Taking an idea for a game isn't bad, right? League of Legends looking at Dota and saying we could do that but better isn't bad, especially considering a lot of the people that worked at Riot and founded it used to work on the original Dota mod, but let's move past that. But it's just saying that they liked the idea and they wanted to improve on it and iterate upon it, right? And that's good. That's beneficial to the industry. And it's bad for us to kind of pretend that that's not. And it's bad for us to just try and hide that. And it's bad for us to use terms like RPG and adventure and action game. And what do any of those mean? What do they mean? So if I have a point for this video, that was it. I don't have a conclusion or an end. I didn't really think this through that much, but I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if you think I'm a stupid fucking idiot and that this is a stupid conversation, but if you liked it, you know, I'm going full YouTuber here. You could hit the like button. A lot of people, especially on my Death Note video, people dislike my videos sometimes, and it makes me feel bad about myself. So you could do that too if you want me to feel bad about myself. I'm okay with it. I can handle it. You could also subscribe if you want. I mean, I won't make you. Okay, bye.